Hello, good evening.
Always, good evening.
Always right on time. Good to see you. Guadalupe is here too. Let me give her a regular name so she's not looking like a robot. There we go. I can't hear you. Can you hear me? Can you hear me, Rita?
Yes, Mr. Webb, I can hear you very well.
Okay, good. All right. Guadalupe is having a little problem over there connecting to the audio. Let's hope she can get connected. How about now? Can you hear us?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, fantastic. Welcome. Yeah, you got to push you got to push that connect to audio button or it doesn't work, right? Everybody, a lot of people have that problem at first as they come in and they're unable to hear anything.
But I can hear you now.
Okay, fantastic. Welcome. There's Leonardo coming in. And here is Maria. Hello, everybody.
Hello,
teacher.
How are you doing tonight?
Okay.
Good. It is Tuesday night tonight, right?
Yes.
Very good. Tuesday the 21st. So we're 3 weeks into April. It's April, right?
April, yes.
April. So it's three weeks in April and 2 weeks in March. So we have had 5 weeks of shutdown, huh?
Yes.
5 weeks. My goodness. Well, we're all surviving anyway. We're all surviving. Let's see, what did I do today? Well, I taught my class in the morning, and then I didn't do much, to be honest. I wanted to exercise, but I didn't have time. I was too busy preparing my class. So I ran out of time. Maybe tomorrow I'll get on and do some exercise. Well, I can, my morning class starts at 9 o'clock, so if I don't get up early, I don't get enough time to exercise before the class.
Lupe.
Yes?
Yeah. Teacher, I have a question for you.
Oh, yes, sir, David. Yeah. Sounds like a very serious question, yes?
Today, I'm trying to get in on YouTube and your channel, but I can't.
I couldn't.
That's funny. Did you just go to the regular YouTube?
Yes.
And did you search for the YouTube channel? How did you try to find my channel? Are you a subscriber?
No. I have to do that?
No, you don't have to subscribe, but how were you looking for it?
Just the last time I wrote down web 90041.
Webby with a Y.
Yeah, with a Y. It's
W-E-B-B-Y.
W-E-B-B-Y, yes, 90041.
And it didn't come up?
No.
Let me investigate here.
I must send him a video of you, Mr. Webb, to David. I already sent it to you, David.
Oh, okay.
Thank you, Rita. Thank you.
Okay, copy down the URL.
Yes.
Ready to go. Yeah, and I want to. In fact, I'm glad you mentioned the YouTube because I want to show you something on the YouTube because I have done a little reorganizing, and I want to show you this. So let me share the YouTube screen here. Okay. Share. Okay. Can everybody see the YouTube screen now?
No.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So this is just regular YouTube, right? And you go and search me, Webby 90041. That's my number. And then here's my channel. right? Here's my channel. But I want to show you something. Can you see this?
Yes.
You see the downtown? picture of downtown, yes. And me with my beautiful Dodgers jacket that my wonderful students gave me. All right.
Yes.
And if you push this button, playlists, it says videos and then playlists. You see that button, the second button? You can click on that button. I have organized it by classes, right? So like here's my morning class, but here's our evening class right here. And there should be 8 videos in this section, yeah. So maybe I haven't put up last night's yet, maybe not. Oh no, here it is. April 21st, parent conjunctions, April 8th. Yeah, so all of the classes are here listed in the playlist. You see them? See, that's my class from a couple days ago. When was that? April 20th, tag questions. There you go. You see everybody in the classroom there. So all of our videos are, because there's a bunch of different videos, and some of them are from the morning class, some of them are from my Saturday class, but if you just go to that button that says playlist, you can go right to our class, okay? No problem?
No problem,
teacher.
No problem, very good. All right. Okay, so that's that. Let me stop the share there for a moment. So what are we going to do tonight? Like I said, since we have finished chapter 10, we're going to circle back around to the beginning of the book. And at the beginning of the book, we have information about what we call parts of speech, right? And this can be tricky for students because it's sometimes a little hard to identify what a word is. And if we don't know what the word is, we don't know the proper way to use it. So that's what we're gonna try to do tonight. But first, as usual, let's do our verb warm-up, okay? Now, I sent the verb warm-up out, if you had a chance to print it out. It's, see if I can find it here. It's called... Today is the 21st, right?
Yeah.
Here we go. Here we go. English Review 421. Here we go. Can everybody see it?
Yes.
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 A little bit bigger there. Okay. 421 is today, right? Yes?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. It's confused sometimes. All right. This first one says, I broke my leg while I was rolling skate. Perfect. Well, I was roller skating last summer.
Roller skating.
The next one has that word yet. That's going to be our present perfect, isn't it?
Huh?
So again, as Yolanda.
That's your one. Finish it.
Finished her homework yet.
Finished.
The next one says the teacher to class at about 6 each night.
Came.
Do we say came or comes?
Comes.
I agree. Simple present, right? Because we're talking about every
come.
The next one is a how long question.
How long has the construction crew been digging?
Exactly. How long has the crew been digging? Yeah. Notice the word crew, even though it means many people, is singular. Right? Those are what we call group nouns. Words like team or band or class. It means many people, but it's one unit. So we use singular. All right. The next one has an as soon as. As soon as what? As soon as Mr. Jacobs
Arrives.
Perfecto.
I like your Spanish.
Yes. My 27 words of Spanish that I know. All right, the next one. Well, maybe I know more than 27. I have to get out my Duolingo. All right, let's see. The next one says, next week, John, his resume to many companies.
Wilson.
Or is going to send?
He's going to send.
Will send or is going to send. Perfect. All right. Now the next one, we have to be careful here. This one is more for my fives and sixes. My fours don't, we haven't studied this yet.
We're invited.
There you go. Invited. There's that passive again.
Invited.
50 people were invited to my wedding. Right? Because I invited them. I invited them, so they were invited. The next one says, not so often. What can we say for that?
We haven't seen.
We don't see him in class so often anymore. Not so often. In general, right?
Yeah.
Now the next one, again, we have to be careful. This, what's the subject? The dishes.
Were washed.
But we want to use already.
Have been washed.
Exactly. So we're going to use have. Oops. Have
ready.
Already been
washed.
That's a present perfect passive. Present perfect passive. Again, my fives and sixes need to know that. My fours don't have to worry this semester. Next semester, you'll have to know it, but this semester, you don't have to worry about passive. You'll need to worry about simple present tense passive and simple past, but not present perfect. All right. Now, the next one says, this is what we were talking about, when was it? 2 weeks ago? Remember, we have here, before they found one. That's past tense, right?
Had.
Exactly.
H-A-D.
H-A-D, had looked. Or you could say had been looking. But we want past perfect. Everybody see why? Remember our past perfect lesson?
Había.
If you don't remember, go to the YouTube channel. Watch it again. Right? Past perfect for had. Right? All right. Now the next one. The next one says, at all today. So we're talking about today.
Hasn't been listened?
Didn't listen?
Or doesn't?
We're talking about today, so I like that hasn't better.
Hasn't been listened.
Hasn't listened, or we could say hasn't been listening. Because today is not finished yet, right? Today has started, but it hasn't finished. So maybe he will listen to the radio later, but he hasn't listened to it yet. He hasn't listened to it at all today. So the next one has the word yesterday. Sounds like simple past to me, huh?
I've worked.
Worked,
right. Or you could even say,
We're working.
Remember, for actions that take a long time, we can use continuous verb, no problem.
We're working.
All right, now the next one is a how often question. How often what?
Do you,
perfect.
Do you.
How often do you? Oh, wait a minute, hold it. It's not you, it's your teacher.
How often does?
Does, exactly. How often does your teacher
make
you do homework? How often does your teacher make you do homework? Does make. The next one, tomorrow afternoon, I lunch with my friends.
We'll be.
We'll be having. You could say we'll be having, that's fine. Or we'll have. I'm going to have. All of those are fine. Number 15 is a question about grandpa. Mr. Abuelo.
That's your grandfather, right.
Does your grandfather like ranchera music, right? Does like. General question and singular. In general, singular. Does. Okay. The next one here says, not until next spring. Not until next spring.
Won't take.
Isn't
going to take.
I'm glad I don't have a vacation planned for this year. Just stay in California this year, right? Maybe go to the Grand Canyon. Yeah, maybe no COVID in the Grand Canyon, I don't think. All right. Let's see. Mary will be upset if... Aha! Here's our if, right?
If she fails.
Remember, what is the partner of Will?
Simple present.
Right?
Fails.
She will be upset if she fails the test. The next one is a question about tomorrow.
Will your friends help?
I like that. Will your friends help? Or of course, we could say, are your friends going to help? Number 19 says we will have dinner when the potatoes.
Will be ready?
But we have Will over here. So do we want Will twice? No, that's right.
Are you ready?
When the potatoes are ready. Remember, present and future. Those are our partners. Okay. The next one says, at the moment. At the moment what?
Is interviewing.
Yeah. Very good.
Is interviewing
an applicant for the job. Is interviewing. Ah, 21. Notice what it says over here. It says, before the party. So Andrew got
Should we say has or had?
Had.
H A D, right?
Yes. Had.
Had never.
Had never.
Drunk.
Drunk.
Let me see if I can say that in Spanish. No había tomado. Yes?
Yes,
good Spanish. Okay. All right. If I have questions,
I will call you.
Present and future again. All right. The next one says very early yesterday.
I woke up.
Irregular past tense. Irregular, right? Break and broke, wake and woke. The next one says, we have to read this one carefully. So far this month, and it has that how many question. How many so far?
Are we taking?
Simple present.
Which one do you like? Do we or have we?
Have we taken? Mom, it's not finished yet.
Yeah, remember, whenever we have the how many so far, we want to use present perfect. So, for example, how many times have you used your cell phone today? How many beers has Antonio drunk tonight? Right? How many so far? Present perfect. All right. Number 25. When I got home at 11 last night, what was my wife doing?
Was sleeping.
Finish. Any questions there? Everybody feel good?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. All right. Let's see how many people we have here tonight. 15 people. Not bad at all. Not bad at all. Nice to see you all. Let's see. We have Leonardo, Noel, Edith, Rosendo, Camila. No, that's Rodriguez. Her knee. I always see her knee. Let's see. Guadalupe. Okay. Nice to see everybody. I think it's fantastic that you're keeping going, right? Key point here, even though this is not the perfect way to study English, if we don't study during this time, what happens to our English? Disappears, right? It disappears. We don't want that. We want to keep our English fresh, because if we don't go to school in spring and we don't go to school in summer, it's going to be a disaster. It's going to be back to level one, right? I don't want that. I don't want that for you. We want to stay here in the high level, right? Stay in the high level. So, like I said, we're going to talk about something tonight, which is kind of technical, but it is important. And that is knowing the difference between different words. Every word in English is what we call a part of speech. A part of speech. Now, some parts of speech we learn way back in level one, right? Noun, verb, pronoun. We learn those right away. But other parts of speech we haven't learned yet, and some we will learn tonight. But I want to go over parts of speech a little bit tonight. So I'm going to turn off our microphones for a second, and I'm going to give you a little presentation, and then we're going to do some practicing, okay? Sounds good?
Yes.
Okay.
Very good. All right. Turning off this. Okay, there we go. Nice and quiet for our presentation here. All right, and let me share my screen here. If I can find the proper screen to share. There it is. All right. And all right, everybody give me a thumbs up if you see the screen. And everybody can hear me? Thumbs up again? Yes? Okay, good. All right, categories of words in English, parts of speech. Let's talk about this a little bit tonight. Parts of speech. Notice what it says here. In English, every word is a part of speech. This refers to the word's function in the sentence. There are 8 parts of speech. And let's look at them right now. I can move this over here. There we go. 8 parts of speech. Let's take a look. Nouns and pronouns. We learned those way back in level one, right? Who is she? She is Alicia, right? That's nouns and pronouns. Verbs. Adjectives. Adverbs. Adverbs are, we learned some adverbs a little bit in level two, but not as much as we should. So we need to study them a little bit more tonight. Prepositions, conjunctions. Remember, conjunctions was our big lesson when we were talking about cause and effect. Remember the conjunction of cause and effect? So. And finally, interjections. So these are our 8 forms of speech. Now, there are some groups that are a little bit smaller that fall into all these categories, but basically, there are 8 forms of speech. Sometimes when you look at a paper, you'll see 9, but basically, let's call it 8 and go over each one together. So in the next 8 slides, I'm going to show you each part of speech and highlight what it is and why we use it. Okay, so nouns, pronouns, verbs, adjectives, adverbs, prepositions, conjunctions, and interjections. Okay, let's look at each one of these carefully. Okay, noun, right? Noun are the probably most words in English, if you put them in a pile, the biggest pile would be nouns. Because what are nouns? Nouns are a person, a place, a thing, or an idea. They can be proper nouns, like Julio or Maria or Isadora. Those are called proper nouns. Also, like San Francisco, Los Angeles, New York City. Those are proper nouns. Or Macy's, Target. Those are proper nouns, right? Proper nouns are names of things. Or common nouns. Common nouns are all the other nouns. All the other nouns. And I see I made a little mistake here, so I'm going to fix that right now. Put my parentheses around it. So, okay, there we go. And okay. All right. Notice the red. The red is what we call nouns, right? Henry ate a hot dog at the game and got indigestion. Henry, hot dog, game, indigestion. Those are all nouns because they're people, places, and things. After the movie, Alicia went to the coffee shop with her friends. Noun, 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 right? Movie, Alicia, coffee, shop, friends, those are all nouns because they're people, places, and things. The cat chased the mouse into a hole in the wall. Cat, mouse, hole, wall are all nouns. I like that picture of the cat and the mouse. That's a good photo. All right. So the cat chased the mouse into a hole in the wall. Noun, 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 noun. So as you see, there's a lot of red up there, isn't there? Like I said, nouns are the biggest group of words in English. The biggest group of words in English. Nouns. All right. Pronouns. Pronouns, again, we learn all the way in level one, but there are many different kinds of pronouns. Remember, pronouns are simply words that take the place of nouns. There are many different types of pronouns. For example, the most common pronoun is what we call the personal pronoun. He, they, him, our, their, us, right? Those are all called personal pronouns. Demonstrative pronouns, there are only four, right? This, that, these, those. Only four. This, that, these, and those. So if I say, give me that, that's a pronoun. That. Interrogative pronouns. That's just a fancy word. Usually I call them question words. Technically they're called interrogative pronouns, but which, who, where, when, etc. Those are called interrogative pronouns, but I just call them pronouns. Question words. Indefinite pronouns, like some, none, several. For example, if I say, do you have any pencils? You say, yes, I have several, right? Several is a pronoun. Possessive pronouns, like his and yours, suyo, tuyo, right? Possessive pronouns, they take the place of the noun. Reciprocal pronouns. Reciprocal means that the pronoun is already in the sentence at the beginning of the sentence. For example, each other, one another, or myself, himself, herself, right? ourselves. Those are called reciprocal pronouns. So for example, I am proud of myself. Okay. Somebody told me that we should always be nice to one another. And I believe that, right? Everything you see there is a pronoun in red. Somebody, that's an indefinite pronoun. Me, that's a personal pronoun. We, that's another personal pronoun. One another, that's a reciprocal pronoun. And I believe that we have a personal pronoun and a demonstrative pronoun. All of those are pronouns there in red. So there's a lot of different kinds of pronouns, but they're all doing the same thing. They're changing the noun into the pronoun. So instead of saying, I called Rebecca, I will say, I called her, right? Instead of saying, I need some pickles, I can just say, I need some, right? So I don't have to say the noun. I never say the noun and the pronoun together. I say one or the other. Pronouns replace nouns, okay? Next one, verbs. Verbs, again, we spend the most time talking about verbs in English class because verbs are so tricky because they change the tenses, right? Present tense, past tense, future tense, verb, 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 verb. All of those are verbs. So every day when we practice, what are we practicing? Verbs, right? Most forms most verbs are the action in the sentence, though some verbs show the state or the condition. And this is what we talked about a little bit last night. They can be either transitive with an object or intransitive with no object. Transitive, intransitive. Let me show you some examples. A carpenter is someone who builds things with wood. Is a verb. Build is a verb. Luis paid his workers and gave everyone a bonus, right? Those are actions. Pay and give are actions. So they are verbs. I know this looks scary, but actually it is very safe. Right? Again, no, look, is, verbs. Those are all verbs, right?
Right.
Yeah, no and look are what we call non-continuous verbs. We don't use ing with them. But they're still verbs, even though they're not describing actions. They're describing the appearance of something. All right, so those are verbs. Muchos, hay muchos in English. Probably one of your teachers have given you a big list of verbs, 200, 300, 400 verbs, right? Probably in English, you will understand English pretty well if you know maybe 300 or 400 verbs, right? That's not all of them, but that's a lot of them. All right, adjectives. Adjectives are descriptors, right? What do they describe? Nouns. And let's remember what nouns are. What are nouns? People, places, and things. So anything that describes a person, a place, or a thing is an adjective. For example, Alberta looks beautiful in her new dress. Beautiful is an adjective. New is an adjective. We're going to talk much more about adjectives later tonight. But for now, let's just look at them. Beautiful, new, both adjectives. You're so kind to me. You are my best friend. Right? Kind is an adjective. My is what we call a possessive adjective. Still an adjective. And friend. Best, excuse me. Best is an adjective. That's what we call a superlative adjective, but it's still an adjective. I thought the movie was funny, but my wife found it boring. Remember, we talked about participle adjectives like in the second lesson we had this year, or this semester anyway. Boring, interesting, exciting. They look like verbs because they have ing, but actually they're adjectives. They're called participle adjectives. My, again, funny. My son has an old car and it looks ugly. Right? Ooh, that car is not great. Right? Again, my, old, ugly. Those are all adjectives. Why? Because I'm describing a person, son, and a thing, car. Right? Whenever you describe people, places, or things, you use adjectives. Now, where we get confused is we have two different kinds of words to describe. The second kind of word, little note here before we go on. Note, the words a, an, and the are called articles, and they fit into this category. So, a, an, and the are like a special three. They're adjectives, but they're special adjectives. They're adjectives, but they serve a special purpose. They're different than the other adjectives. They're still adjectives, but they're called articles. We call those articles. And every article is an adjective. All right, now, adverbs. This one is where people get mixed up. Like adjectives, adverbs describe. However, remember, however, sin embargo, they describe verbs, adjectives, or other adverbs. They often end in L-Y. Example, you play the piano beautifully and sing wonderfully. Beautifully, wonderfully are describing actions. How do you play the piano? Beautifully. How do you sing? Wonderfully. I hope I do well on the next exam. It is coming soon. Right? Again, well is an adjective describing how I do on the exam. Soon is an adjective describing when the test is coming. I don't think your jokes are very funny. Now, funny, of course, is an adjective, right? We talked about that in the last slide. But very is an adverb. Remember, adverbs describe adjectives. So whenever you have very funny, or really expensive, or extremely hot, that first word is an adverb. The second word is an adverb, adjective. There's my special effect. We easily won the game because the other team played poorly. Notice with an adverb, you have some flexibility. Here I put the adverb in front of the verb, and here I put the adverb after the verb. They're both okay. Adjectives are more strict. Adverbs have flexibility in where you can put them. Okay? All right, so that's the adjective and adverb. We're going to talk much more about that after the presentation. But we have three more things to look at, or two more, I think. Preposition. Preposition are all those little words in English, right? The connectors. In, on, at, to, from, by, about. Those are prepositions. Example, Your blouse is in the closet and your shoes are under the bed. In and under are prepositions. During the movie, the guy behind me was talking to his friend. During, behind, to are all prepositions. Thank you for helping me on this job. I can't finish without you. Everybody remembers 2 weeks ago when we talked about cause and effect, right? Or was it last week? Last week we talked about it. Cause and effect, remember we had two prepositions. Because of and due to. Remember those two from last week? Prepositions. Before class, we met at Starbucks to talk about our day. So in English, there are probably, I don't know, 50, 60 prepositions. In, under, during, behind, to, for, on, without, before, at, about. These are all prepositions. Like I said, there's probably 40, 50 prepositions in English. Not a lot, but a lot if you're trying to memorize them. Right. So there's some, all of those are examples of prepositions. Okay. All right. The last one. Oh, not the last one. Conjunction. This is our old friend from our lessons last week. Remember the conjunction we had? So. But there are other conjunctions. For example, remember conjunction always links two equal grammar structures together. For example here, two gerunds. I enjoy fishing and camping.
Camping.
What is and? A conjunction.
Conjunction.
He is neither friendly nor polite. Two adjectives. What is that? A conjunction.
Conjunction.
Franklin went to the zoo, but didn't see the zebras. But is a conjunction. I want to learn English and get a better job. I want to learn English and get a better job. Two infinitives. We can leave on Tuesday. Or on Wednesday. I lost my passport, so I need to get a new one. This is the one we were practicing last week. So, in English, there are only seven conjunctions. Seven. It's a very small group. The smallest group in English, only seven in that group. Conjunctions, only seven. We'll talk in more detail about conjunctions at another time. But here, just know the conjunctions are seven. All right, and the final group called an interjection. An interjection. An interjection is something you say with emotion. Right? Interjections are words that are added to express strong emotion. They have their own special categories as part of speech. For example, wow, you have an amazing comic book collection, right? Wow is an interjection. Holy cow, I can't believe the price of gasoline at this station. Holy cow is an interjection. Technically, it's an adjective and a noun, but we use it as an interjection. Ouch! You just stepped on my toe and it hurts. Ouch is an interjection. Darn! We missed the last train of the night. Now, there are many interjections I'm not going to tell you because I'm a good Christian man, and I don't use those words. But there are many interjections that are bad words, so you have to go someplace else to learn them. I'm not going to tell you those interjections. Blech! This food is terrible. That poor boy has some bad salsa or something. Blech! The food is terrible. So, wow, holy cow, ouch, darn, blech. These are called interjections. And there are many, and they're fun to use because they always show your emotion. Either you're happy, you're excited, you're angry. We use these words to express emotion. So here we have our final slide. It says, wow, you made it to the end of the presentation. And I'm sure you will pass the next test easily. Oh, okay. So let's take a look at this here. Okay. Oh, let's go back. Let me go back to this slide. Okay. And I'm going to turn on everybody's microphone. Oops. Everybody can hear me now?
Yes.
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 All right. Going very fast through this to the end because I want you to do a little practice for me when we get to the end of this presentation. It's going super fast. Here we go. Almost done. Here we go. Interjections. Wow. Holy cow. Ouch. Darn. Blick. Okay. Here we are at the last slide again. I want to see if you can identify these words. How about the word wow? What kind of speech is that?
Interjection.
Interjection, right? That's the one we just had. What about made?
Verb.
Verb, right. Made is a verb. What about to?
Preposition.
Preposition, sure. What about presentation?
Noun.
Noun. What about and?
Conjunction.
Conjunction. What about sure?
No.
Or no.
Pardon?
Conjunction. Conjunction.
No, I'm describing myself. I am sure.
Adverbio.
Adjective, right.
Adjective.
Adjective. Adjective. How about you?
A noun.
Noun or pronoun?
Pronoun.
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 And easily?
Adverbio.
Adverb. Okay. Adverb. So there we have all eight forms of speech. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Interjection. Verb. Preposition.
Preposition.
Noun.
Noun.
Conjunction.
Conjunction.
Adjective.
Adjective.
Pronoun.
Pronoun.
And
adverb.
Adverb. There we go. No problems?
No, not for today.
Not too bad, not too bad. All right, I'm going to stop the share for a second. Hello, everybody.
Hello.
All right. All right, let's practice this a little bit together. Then we're going to practice about adjectives and adverbs in particular. All right, Guadalupe. I'm going to give you a word, Guadalupe. And yeah. I want you to see if you can put it in a category, okay? I'm going to give you a word and see if you can put it in a category. So, for example, yeah. if I say eat, that's a verb, right?
Yeah.
Everybody got the idea? So remember, we have those eight categories, All right, let's see. All right. Guadalupe, what kind of word is she?
Pronoun. She? Pronoun?
Pronoun.
Pardon?
It's pronounced?
A pronoun, right? Pronoun. She is a pronoun. Very good. Maria Mendoza.
She.
What about the word book? Book. What do you think,
noun.
Maria?
Noun.
Noun. Very good. Noun. Although, as we know, sometimes you can use book as a verb. For example, I need to book my flight. So sometimes it can be a verb. Yeah, that's the tricky thing. Sometimes it changes depending on the situation. All right, David Segovia.
Yes.
What about the word communication? Communication.
It's
a verb.
Communication, teacher.
Communication.
Hello. I can't hear you well, teacher.
We were having a little problem with the sound, yeah. Communication.
Is that verb?
Oh.
Isadora says verb. Do you agree, David? Communication.
He's a good teacher.
What do you think?
I think so.
Everybody agree? Communication.
No.
What do you think it is?
It's a noun.
It's a noun, right? Communication is a noun. Communicate is a verb, but communication is a noun, right? All of those words that end with T-I-O-N, action, communication, dedication, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. All of those words are nouns. T-I-O-N is always going to be a noun. Yeah, and you'll notice there are endings. Remember, the ending of the word will always tell you what kind of word it is. So, for example, we had in the presentation, L-Y, right? L-Y tells you it's an adverb. But on the other hand, T-I-O-N tells you it's a noun. All right, let's see. Isadora, what about the word... what about the word investigate? Investigate.
Investigate. Is thinking?
Investigate.
Investigate.
Investigate. Is a verb?
Is that an action or a thing?
Investigate is a verb, no?
It's a verb, right. Investigate is a verb.
Action.
Yeah. Investigation is a noun.
It's a noun.
Investigate is a verb. All right, Jose Garcia.
Yep.
Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
What about the word field? Field.
Huh?
Pardon?
I can hear you.
Yeah, we're having a problem with the speaker tonight. Field.
Field?
Yes. F-I-E-L-D. Like a soccer field.
Oh, a soccer field. Noun?
Noun, field. Right. It's a place. A field is a place, so it's a
el
noun.
El campo. El campo, yes.
Campo, yes, exactly. Julio Contreras.
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.
What about the word quickly?
Quickly.
Adverb? L-Y. Adverb. L-Y means adverb. Most of the time. There are a few words that end with L-Y that are not, like friendly. Friendly is an adjective, but quickly is an adverb. Quickly.
Quickly is an adverb.
All right, let's see. Claudia.
Quickly.
What about the word, new? N-E-W, new, nuevo.
Oh, new is an adjective.
Adjective, perfect. New is an adjective because it describes things. I have a new car. I have a new pencil. I have a new wife. Right? New. All right. Edith.
Yes.
Are you ready? Maybe. What about the word... what about the word... Ouch.
Out?
Ouch.
Ouch.
Ouch. Ouch. Ouch. Ouch. I just dropped the pencil on my foot.
Interjection?
Interjection, right. Ouch is an interjection. Good. Let's see. Jennifer.
Yes.
What about the word into? Into.
Into?
Go into the store. Yeah.
Verb?
Not a verb. Preposition? Go part is a verb. Preposition.
Preposition?
Go into shows the location or direction, right? Go into the store. Into is a preposition.
It's a preposition.
All right. Let's see. David Segovia, I already asked you a question, right? Moved around on my screen. All right, Noel.
Yes.
What about the word handsome? Whenever I see Noel, I think handsome.
Handsome. Adverb?
Not adverb. Adjective, right?
Adjective.
Because it describes a person, adjective. Right? That man is handsome. It describes a person, so it's an adjective. All right. Rosendo.
Yes.
What about the word under? Under.
Preposition.
Preposition?
Two votes for preposition, Rosendo. Do you agree?
I'm gonna go for them. Yeah, for that.
Preposition, yes, I agree. Preposition is correct. Correct. Preposition. All right, Rita.
Yes.
What about the word sunshine? Sunshine.
Sunshine.
There's a lot of sunshine today. Sunshine on my shoulders makes me happy, if you know that.
Adjective?
Well, shine is a verb, but what about sunshine?
Sunshine.
Adjective?
Adjective? Adjective?
Noun. Sunshine
Noun.
Right?
Noun.
Noun. So you say, for example, there is a lot of sunshine today, right? Noun. Or I love the sunshine. Noun. All right, let's see. Galaxy Core Prime. I don't know who that is. I don't know. Galaxy Core Prime, identify yourself. I don't know. I'll have to skip her. Ed Vegas.
Hello.
You there? Oh, maybe is Leonardo? Is that you, Leonardo?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. It's Leonardo. Okay, I have to change your name here. Okay, hold it. Let me give you a new name so I can see who you are. Leonardo. Okay. All right, Leonardo. What about the word closet?
Can you repeat?
Closet. Like my jacket is in the closet.
Closet.
No.
Closet.
It's a noun?
Noun, correct. Closet is a noun.
Yeah.
And Rodriguez.
Yes.
What about the word understand?
Understand. Adverb.
Not an adverb.
Verb.
Verb, right? Understand is what you do, right? It's an irregular verb. Understand, understood. Irregular verb. All right. Are you ready to practice a little bit more? Sure, why not?
Yes.
Why not? Let's give it some more practice if I can find the correct website here. All right, let me see here. Okay, share this. All right, let me see. Okay, can everybody see the website?
Yeah.
Yes, teacher.
You say, do you read this sentence? Hunter made a sandwich of brown lettuce, old mayonnaise, and stale bread?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so we're going to go through each word and see if we can figure out what they are. All right, here's the word hunter. Okay, is it a preposition, adjective, conjunction, verb, or noun? Hunter.
No.
That's a person, right? What about made?
Verb.
Good. What about
preposition.
Now remember, a, an, and the are
conjunction
adjectives.
Oh,
a, an, and the are articles. Articles, yeah. Are conjunctions. Oh, there's Leonardo again. Okay. Sandwich. What about sandwich? Noun. Of.
Preposition.
Preposition. Good. Brown.
Noun. Oh, adjective.
Adjective, right. It could be a noun, the word brown. If you say, like, my favorite color is brown, that's a noun. But this one, it says a brown bread, right? Describing the bread. All right, what about lettuce?
Noun.
Lettuce is a noun, it's a thing, right? What about old?
Adjective,
describing the sandwich or the mayonnaise, actually. What about mayonnaise?
Noun.
And?
Conjunction.
Stale. Does everybody know that word stale?
No.
Have you heard the word stale before?
No.
Stale? Stale means the opposite of fresh.
Oh, okay.
Right? It's not fresh, it's stale. So what kind of word would that be?
Adjective.
Right. Because we're describing the bread.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Noun. And finally, bread?
Noun.
All right, let's check. Correct, 100%. I can't believe it. Fantastic. All right. Let's do another sentence. Okay, here's the sentence. The fat frog snatched flies from the air with its long tongue. All right, the fat frog snatched flies from the air with its long tongue. All right, let's practice this a little bit. What can we say there?
Conjunct.
The is?
Conjunct.
Adjective. Remember, a, an, and the are adjectives.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're describing something, right? All right, what about fat?
Adjective.
Describing the frog. What about frog?
Noun.
Right, exactly. All animals are nouns, right? All animals are noun. Snatch. Do you know this word snatch?
No.
Bear.
Well, it has an ED, so what do you think it is?
Bear.
A verb, bear? Of course, right? Everything with ED is going to be a verb, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's a snatch.
Snatch means to take very quickly.
Oh.
Like somebody snatched my purse. To take quickly.
Oh, okay.
What about flies? Now be careful. This fly is like the mosca, right?
La mosca.
Noun.
So it's a noun, right? It's an insect. Noun. All right. From.
Preposition,
right? The connector. The connector. Good. Preposition. The.
Adjective.
Good. A, an, and the are adjectives. Air.
Noun.
Very good. With.
Preposition.
Preposition.
Good. It's.
Pronoun.
Actually, well, we'll see. I'm going to see how smart this connector is. Technically, this is an adjective, but I think maybe, I don't know. It all depends on how smart the guy who made this is. We'll write adjective and see what happens. Because it is an adjective. How about long?
Any meaning?
Adjective.
Long is an adjective, right? And tongue?
Noun.
A noun. Good. All right. Check my work. I knew it. See this. Here. Let me show you this on my board, because the person who made this made a very common mistake, and I don't blame this person. He's probably a good teacher, but he made one little mistake, and I didn't realize this myself for a long time. Right. When we talk about pronouns, there are two things. There's one that's called a possessive adjective, and that is my, your, his, her, It's
possessive adjective.
Our and their. Right? And we always use these words. And let me see if I can find mine. Right? We always use these words with a noun. Right? My book, your pencil, his car, her zebra, its tongue, our DVD player, their house, right? We always use these words with a noun. On the other hand, we have the other ones called possessive pronouns. And this is always a big trick for people who speak Spanish, because the pronouns can confuse people. All right, so for example, pronouns are mine, yours, his, hers, its, ours, and theirs. Right? And we always use these with nothing else. Right? If you remember, in level one, we had some lessons like this. I would say, is this your pencil? And I'd say, yes, it's mine. Right? Right? These are what used by themselves. They're pronouns. These are used with nouns. They are adjectives. So the person who made that little practice made a little bit of a mistake. And I don't blame him, because this is a little bit tricky. In fact, I didn't know it myself until I started to be an English teacher. This is something you don't even think about. But these are called adjectives. These are called pronouns. Why are these adjectives? Because they're used with a noun. Why are these pronouns? Because they replace the noun. Right? Okay. Anyway, let me go back to what we were practicing. And let's do one more of these, and then we'll talk about one more thing here. Okay, I'm gonna share this again. Here we go. So this is a pronoun, and we'll check it again. Okay, yeah, it's not really a pronoun, but we don't mind. Okay, all right. So here's another one. While Priscilla crunched salty pretzels, Peter, her brother, assembled the bicycle. All right. What about while?
Preposition?
No. Mm-hmm. While, technically, I like to call while a clause connector so we don't get confused.
Clause connector?
Clause connectors fall into the category of conjunctions, because they connect their conjunctions. All right. What about Priscilla?
Noun.
What about crunched?
Verb.
ED.
You got it. What about salty?
Adjective.
Describing the pretzels. What about pretzels?
Noun.
All food is noun, right?
Peter.
What about
noun.
Peter?
Noun.
Her brother. Now
pronoun.
Again,
pronoun.
We're going to write pronoun even though it's actually a noun. Brother.
Noun.
Assembled.
Verb.
You guys are getting good. The.
Adjective.
Bicycle.
Noun.
I like it. Perfect. All right, let's do one more and then we're going to go on to something different. All right. After Jeff dripped jam on his white shirt, He licked the fabric. Ooh, that's disgusting. All right, what can we do here?
Conjunction.
After the conjunction, right? All right. No. What about Jeff? Jeff is a noun.
Noun.
Dripped.
Beber.
Verb. Jam.
Noun.
Noun, right?
Oh, noun.
Because it's a thing. Remember, all food is an is nouns. On.
Preposition.
Preposition, right? And his
pronoun.
Again, we're gonna write pronoun, even though it's an adjective.
Pronoun.
White.
Adjective. Noun.
Adjective. Shirt.
Adjective. Noun.
Noun. Noun. He.
Preposition.
Pronoun.
Licked.
Verb.
The.
Pronoun. Adjective.
And fabric.
Noun.
Very good. And check. Correct. Perfect. Okay. I'm going to send you this link so you can practice whenever you want to, okay?
Yes.
So I'm going to send you this link right now, if I can. Okay. My website is not responding very well. Let's see. Let's try it again here. All right, I'll send it to you after class. Sorry, my website's not working. Oh, here we go. All right, hold on. No, it doesn't want to work. All right. Okay, there we go. ESL level 456. Okay. All right. Send you a message to ESL 456. Okay. There we go. I will remember not to do this during the class anymore. Yeah, it's just taking too long. Yeah. The problem is this app does not work very well when there are so many things running. All right. I'll do it after class. I promise. All right, I promise I will do that after class. Okay, good. All right, now, let me share one thing in particular tonight, and then we're gonna talk more about this tomorrow, because this is a tricky thing, right? Nouns and verbs are pretty easy to distinguish, right? Nouns and verbs are pretty easy to distinguish, right? A noun is a person, place, a thing. A verb is an action. But it's difficult to distinguish between adjectives and adverbs. And that's what I want to focus on these last few minutes of class. And then we're going to practice more tomorrow. Tonight was kind of the introduction. All right. So, adjectives. What did we say that an adjective describe?
A noun.
Right. Describe nouns. Right. And adjectives have two positions in English. And this is always a little tricky for people who speak Spanish, because in Spanish, you put the adjective usually after the noun.
The noun.
Usually after the noun, but that's not what we do in English, right?
No.
We can put it in front of a noun.
La Casa Blanca, the White House.
Yeah, Casa Blanca, but we say White House, right? So, So for example, So there's an example of using an adjective in front of a noun, right? The big dog chased a little cat around the huge yard, right? Big dog, little cat, huge yard. In front the noun, in front the noun, in front the noun. Right? The second place we can use it is after a linking verb. And linking verbs are like be, become, look, seem, appear, etc. There are more, but that's some examples. So for example,
o si no me voy para allá.
Right? For example, Herbert is tall. He became angry. The pizza looks delicious. You seem upset. He appears tired, right? Is, became, look, seem, appear. Those are what we call linking verbs. And a linking verb can be used with an adjective, right? Now this is going to be important when I talk about adverbs, because most verbs we use with adverbs. Except these special linking verbs. Why do we use an adjective? Because these are not actions. These are not actions. If I say the pizza looks delicious, is that an action?
No.
No, I'm just describing the pizza, right?
Yes.
I'm describing the pizza. Or if I say you seem upset, am I describing an action? No. I'm describing you. Right? Mm-hmm. So these are verbs, but we use them with adjectives. They're a special group. They're called linking verbs. And one important note. Important to remember, and this is something that Spanish is not your friend. All adjectives are singular. And this is the big problem for people who speak Spanish. Because in Spanish, you have to be very careful, right? If you have, for example, one intelligent person, you would say un hombre inteligente, right? But yes. If you have two intelligent men, you say dos hombres inteligentes, inteligente. Right? You've got to put that S on your adjective. Mm-hmm. Not in English. So this is a mistake I see every semester. People trying to put S's on adjectives. It's good Spanish. It's bad English. So when I speak Spanish, I have to remember, oh, I need an S in plural. But remember, the only thing that can be plural in English is a noun. We never use S's on adjectives, never. Okay? So those are the important things about adjectives. Now, adverbs. Let's talk about that. What? And remember, adverbs describe verbs, yes, adjectives.
And adjectives.
Adjectives. and other adverbs.
Mr. Webb, you say one example, important things.
Right. Yeah, okay, let me give you an example, right? So
you say important things, right?
Right, right. Let me show you what I mean.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so I have one important person in my life. Okay, but I have two important
persons
in my life. Right? The uh-huh. adjective doesn't change. The adjective doesn't change. Right? If you have a, it doesn't matter. I need an S on my noun, sure. But my point is there's no S on my adjective.
Uh-huh.
Right? Because you would say what? Cosas importantes. Right?
Uh-huh.
But we don't do that in English. No S on adjective. Okay? All right. Hopefully that clears things up. All right. So let's talk about adverbs. All right. Adverbs describe adjectives, verbs, and other adverbs. So let's give you an example of each. All right? I ran quickly. Describing a verb, right? Mm-hmm. I'm really tired. Describing an adjective. Finally, right, this printer works very slowly. The word very is an adverb, sorry, describing another adverb, slowly. So, really, very, and quickly are all adverbs. I would make them, let's see if I can... Is there a place where I can underline? Let me see here. So, very right here. Oops. And really right here. And quickly right here. Are all adverbs. Now, where can we put adverbs? Where can we put adverbs? Let me show you. All right. Usually put adverbs after a verb. I tried hard, but I lost badly. Right? I tried hard, but I lost badly. Right? Hard and badly are both adverbs because we're describing verbs. And where's the position after the verb? Sometimes we use adverbs in the middle of the sentence. Not necessarily always after the verb. For example, I usually eat lunch at home. I usually eat lunch at home. What happened to my board? Donde está? Do you still see the board?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, but the teacher doesn't. Yes. The teacher doesn't see it. That's the problem. Oh, there it is. Okay. Make this bigger. Okay. So I usually eat lunch at home. Notice, where do I have usually? It's in front of the verb. That happens sometimes. Or sometimes we put an adverb at the beginning of the sentence. Sometimes we put the adverb at the beginning of the sentence. For example, let me think of one. For example, unfortunately, we lost our map. Right? Unfortunately is at the beginning of the sentence, but it's still an adverb. So adverbs have a lot more flexibility. A lot more flexibility than adjectives. Okay. Can I erase this side over here?
Yes.
I can erase that part? Okay, so let's do a little practice here. I'm gonna write a sample on the board and then we're gonna practice, okay? So I want you to copy this down from the board and then we're gonna practice. Let's do this little practice tonight. Notice what do we have here? Adjective in front of the noun, adverb after the verb. Adjective in front of the noun, adverb after the verb. Okay, so he's a polite speaker. You're right, he speaks very politely. Notice, adjective, polite. Adverb, politely. Politely. Okay. Everybody got the idea?
Yeah. Can you repeat that, teacher?
The adjective in front of the noun, And the adverb is after the verb.
Oh, okay.
The adjective is in front of the noun. Speaker is a noun because it's a person. So we have the polite in front. And speak is in front of the adjective because we have politely. Okay, no problem?
No problem.
All right, let's do one practice because we're almost out of time, but let's do one practice all together. I'm gonna stop the share and we're gonna work together for one real quick thing. Okay, with everybody who's here. All right, everybody ready?
Yes.
So I'm gonna say an adjective and a noun and you're gonna change it to a verb and an adverb. All right, so Guadalupe, I'll start with you. Are you ready, Guadalupe?
No.
All right, I'll say he is a neat writer. He's a neat writer.
He's a neat writer?
You're gonna say, that's right.
That's.
Or I agree, what did I write? I agree, that's right.
I agree with it.
Okay, so he writes.
He writes.
Very.
Very neatly.
Neatly. Right, he writes very neatly. He's a neat writer. He writes very,
very, very neatly.
Good. Maria Mendoza.
Neatly.
He is a quick learner. He is a quick learner.
I. That's right.
So I agree.
I agree.
He learns very quickly.
He learns.
He learns.
Very quickly.
Very quickly.
There we go. He learns very quickly. He's a quick learner. You're right. He learns very quickly. All right, Isadora. He is a careless driver.
He drives very carelessly.
Carelessly, right. He drives very carelessly. Very good. David Segovia.
Yes, teacher.
He is a careful painter. He is a careful painter.
Teacher?
Painter.
Oh, painter.
Painter. He's a careful painter.
He paint very
carefully.
Right, carefully. He paints very carefully. Looks like Leonardo is not there, so we're gonna jump over her and go to Claudia.
I hear.
You're there. I didn't see your face. I see your ceiling. Okay, you're here. Good. All right, so Leonardo, let me ask you a question. I just see your ceiling there. All right? All right. Leonardo,
yes.
He is a very fashionable dresser. He's a very fashionable dresser. He's a fashionable dresser.
Okay. All right.
Fashionably. Yeah, let's say that together. Fashionably. Everybody knows the word fashionable, right?
Fashionable
means everything looks good, right? Good fashion.
Yes.
Fashionably. He dresses very fashionably.
Fashionable.
All right. Okay. Let's see. Maria Ponce de Leon.
Yes.
He is a very honest businessman. He's a very honest businessman.
That's right. He is so, so very he,
He does business.
He does business. That business?
He does business. Very.
Very.
He's an honest businessman. So honestly, how does he do business?
Honestly,
right? He does business very honestly. He's an honest businessman. He does business very honestly. Honestamente, right?
Does business is very honestly.
Honestly, there you go. Honestly, honestly. All right. Let's see. Julio.
Yes.
She is a nice babysitter. She is a nice babysitter.
He's a nicely.
She babysits.
She babysits nicely.
Very nicely. She babysits very nicely. All right. Jose Garcia.
Yes, teacher.
He is a slow runner. He is a slow runner.
He runs slowly.
He runs slowly. Very good. He's a slow runner. He runs slowly. Claudia.
Yes,
teacher. Claudia. She is a beautiful singer. She is a beautiful singer.
You sing beautifully?
She sings beautifully.
For Claudia.
Yeah.
One more time, Claudia.
She sings very beautifully.
She sings very beautifully. Very nice. All right. Let me see. David Segovia.
Yes, sir.
Let's see. You already did one, didn't you? I asked you, did I already ask you a question? Yes?
Yes, teacher.
Oh, okay, I'll ask you one more just for fun. Okay? Let's see.
Okay.
He is a persuasive speaker.
He speaks persuasively,
right?
Persuasive.
Yeah. Persuasive. You have that word in Spanish, yeah, right? Persuasive.
Persuasively,
right? He speaks persuasively.
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 Persuasively, right?
Persuasively.
All right. Persuasively. All right.
Rosendo. Yes.
He's a very graceful dancer.
He dances gracefully.
All right, Rita. Are you there, Rita? There we go. Let's see. He is a careful driver. He drives very carefully. Very good. And Edvigas, finally, last question.
Okay.
She is a thorough cleaner. She is a thorough cleaner.
Cheese.
Does everybody know that word? Thorough?
No.
Let me put it on the board. Let me see. Okay, let me share that. Okay, let me erase all this. All right, I said he's a thorough cleaner. You know that word thorough?
No.
Thorough means complete. Yeah, very, very complete. So we say what? He cleans.
He cleans it thoroughly.
Very
thoroughly.
He cleans very thoroughly.
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 Thoroughly. Yes, he cleans thoroughly. All right. Welcome back. All right, good. I think that's enough for tonight. We're going to talk more about adjectives and adverbs tomorrow because it's a little tricky, right? It's a little tricky.
Thank you, teacher.
So we'll have another lesson about it tomorrow. I don't want to go on to something new if we don't understand this yet. So more adjectives and adverbs tomorrow, and then on Wednesday we'll move on to something different, okay? Oh, wait a minute. Tomorrow is Wednesday, right?
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Well, okay. So we'll do adjectives and adverbs tomorrow and then something else on Thursday, okay?
All right.
Okay.
Sounds good? All right. Yes. And I'm going to send you that link as soon as we go off the line. So if you want to practice more right now, you can go right ahead and do that. Okay, no problems, everybody?
No problem.
Gracias a todos. Thank you very much.
Thank you, teacher.
I will see you again tomorrow. Oh, we're almost done. Is today Wednesday or Tuesday? Today's Tuesday, right?
Yes.
So we have Wednesday and one more day Thursday. Okay. Two more days this week. All right.
Two very good. Days.
So I'm going to send you that link right now if you want to practice more. And I'll talk to you all again tomorrow more about adjectives and adverbs. Okay?
Okay.
Right. Okay. Hasta la vista, baby. See you later. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Everybody wave.
Bye-bye.
See you later. Bye-bye. So long. Farewell.